Today, the U.S. Supreme Court listened to arguments on Arizona's immigration law, and the outcome could affect Arkansas.
Some have called Arizona's law racial profiling. Others say it's necessary to crack down on illegal immigration. 4029's Jay Plyburn is live tonight to explain how. Jay?
Yeah, guys, thousands of people drive this stretch of Interstate 540 every day, and many of them are Hispanic. In fact, recent statistics show that roughly 25,000 Hispanics live in Springdale alone, which is nearly a third of the population. If the immigration law passes in Arizona, more states could follow suit, and with such a high Hispanic population here in the state of Arkansas, it could have a detrimental effect.
And if that law crosses over to here, we're going to move and keep going to different stages where they don't have that law. That's like humiliating us, because they're going to stop us. The first thing they're going to ask is for a green card.
You know, we are already looking at it, that, you know, a lot of our Spanish people are getting pulled over, and they just, you know, just thrown in jail. And, I mean, I don't like it.
Driving through Springdale, it's easy to see that there's a large Hispanic population, and it's growing every year. But the immigration law that's being discussed in Arizona could change everything if it passes.
This law places an undue burden on people suspected of being here illegally. That means that if a person appears that they do not belong here, they can be arrested without a warrant.
It's been a topic of controversy for years, and a decision in the high-profile immigration case is expected in June. Worthen says if it passes, other states like Arkansas could introduce copycat laws.
Our community is becoming more inclusive, and we're embracing diversity. People are moving here because they know that this is a great place to work, live, and to raise a family. And so this particular law would tear a community apart.
She fears that Hispanics would be arrested left and right, which could drastically affect our economy.
That person that is detained or arrested could be your next door neighbor. It could be your child's best friend. It could be the person that you go to church with. It could be the person that you sit next to calling the hogs at a Razorback game.
Worthen says she believes we need to put the burden on the federal government to take care of the broken immigration system, because it's their job, not ours. Craig and Angela, back to you.
Okay, Jay. Thank you. Reporting live tonight.